So Gibran's question was, can I recite the first five verses of Surah Al-Waqi'ah and the first five verses of Surah Al-Mulk in the same rak'ah? As stated before the break, a similar incident, but not exactly, happened at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, when one of the companions used to lead the congregation, and after or before reciting the additional surah after Fatiha, he used to recite قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ. So his companion said, listen, either you only recite this surah, Surah Al-Ikhlas, or you recite this, the longer version of the other surah, but do not combine them both. So the man said to them, well, this is what I have. You don't like what you hear, you don't like what you see, then in this case, choose another imam. So they went to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and they complained, Prophet of Allah, this man is doing so and so. So the Prophet said to them, ask him, why do you read it? So the man replied, because it has a description of Allah and I love it. So the Prophet said to them, tell him that Allah loves him for that. Now, one of the three types of sunnah is approvals. So the Prophet approved him doing this, alayhi salatu wasalam, which means that it is permissible, but it is not a sunnah. What do you mean, Shaykh? It's permissible, but it is not sunnah. It means that if you do it, you're not doing anything sinful, but you're not recommended to do it. Why? The companion did it. Yes, but the Prophet had never done it in his life, which means that the best is not to recite Surah Al-Ikhlas every single rak'ah as this great companion did, as the scholars had clarified to us. So to recite this surah is permissible. Now the problem is that when you recite five verses of Surah Al-Waqi'ah or any other surah, and then follow that by other verses from another surah, people who are listening to you would probably think that these are connected. So you made a mistake, and instead of going to verse number 6 of Surah Al-Waqi'ah, you went to verse number so-and-so of Surah Al-Mulk. So they might correct you while you're doing it intentionally. So they correct you and you continue, and this would cause confusion. If it were an isolated surah, then there would not be any problem. So if you recite the Fatiha and then you recite Wattini wa Zaytun, and after you finish Wattini wa Zaytun, people know that the surah is over, and you recite Qul A'udhu bi Rabbin Nas, no one will correct you because they know this is a new surah. But if you read a couple of verses of Surah Al-Baqarah and then jump 100 verse and you recite Ayat al-Kursi, and then you jump another 120 or so verses and you recite, for example, not 120, actually, 25 or 30 verses, and you recite Amana Rasul bima unzilihim rabbihi wal mu'minun, the end of Surah Al-Baqarah. This would definitely cause a lot of confusion that this is uncalled for, and hence one should not do it, and Allah knows best.